pleasure, this temperature, this moment. We intertwine into each other's rhythm. Living my life like it's golden. That's going to be our anthem for this show. I am super excited. Here we are. Finally, Playtime is Over. Radio is in the building. Can we get some excitement? Woo-hoo! Woo! Get it, woo woo! Hey, everybody. Welcome to the show. I am Cheryl Wood, your host. And I have to say, I'm a little giddy right now. I have a whole array of emotions going on. I'm giddy. I'm excited. I'm nervous. I'm anxious. So after this is over, I'm probably going to just go and take a nap. What do you guys think?
Yeah, I say celebrate, celebrate.
Sheree says celebrate. She'll celebrate it anytime. It doesn't matter. We are so excited to be on the air live. I know that a lot of folks who are in my network on Facebook and Twitter and LinkedIn are excited. They've been tweeting it and posting, and we appreciate you guys. We value your support, and we have some amazing women in the studio, and an amazing young lady too, who's gonna share with us how she is implementing this motto of playtime is over. Let me just tell you a little bit about this, what this show is all about. So if you're looking for drama, if you're looking for negativity or gossip, change the channel, change the station. This is not where you're going to get it. You are going to get strictly positive here. Positive, positive, positive. We are here to help you jumpstart or kickstart or reignite your passion for living your very best life, whether that's related to some life goals or career goals or business goals. That's what we're here for. And so every week, every Tuesday from 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. Eastern time, I got to say Eastern because, you know, this station, WLVS, airs in, I believe, 135 countries.
Wow.
Talk about global impact, right? Sometimes you get those opportunities to really have global impact, and you just got to take the leap and just dive in. So that's what we're doing. So, you know, I'm probably going to fumble sometimes. I'm probably going to mess up some words or mess up somebody's name, but I am in this for the long haul. I'm excited about the journey and all the amazing people I'll get to have live in this studio to share their story and how they're implementing the motto, playtime is over. And so we want you to help us to kick things off by going out to Twitter and Facebook. Our hashtag for this show is hashtag PTIO Radio. PTIO stands for playtime is over. Why do we say that? Because it is just time. Look, game on, right? Life is short. That is just not a cliche. It's the truth. I think Sheree and I, we've lost some dear friends. We lost our dad a couple years ago and some dear friends recently. And we just realized, look, if what you're going to accomplish, you've got to do it now. You just got to jump in with both feet, scared and all. Do it anyway, like I am for this radio show. Scared and all, but I'm doing it anyway. And so we want you to share information about this show. Again, hashtag PTIO Radio. If you're on Facebook, let us know you're out there. If you're on Twitter, send us a tweet. And we're going to give you some dynamic information and hopefully keep you excited about coming back every single week. So shout out to all my Facebook fans and followers and Twitter peeps and all you folks.
The airways are on fire.
On fire. You know, I had to have some amazing people here to kickstart the show with me. So I have with me in the studio live Miss Jennifer Jones. I'm going to tell you a little more about her, but just say hello to the
Good
people.
Good afternoon, Cheryl. It is a blessing of God and just a testament to the amazing woman that you are, that on this day, on this hour, I get to be a part of history in celebrating you starting your radio show.
Awesome.
Playtime is over.
Playtime. You hear that? I'm telling you, it's over. We are doing new things, exciting things. We're stretching ourselves. We're expanding our expectations. A little bit later in the show, I'm going to tell you about something amazing that my daughter and I, we just did this morning, which was super exciting. We're loving this Playtime is over. I don't know if you can see my little thing here, but I wear my bracelet all the time, my little wristband. Playtime is over. We also have Sheree Cofield in the building.
In the building, Twin Powers.
Twin Powers.
On the airways. They're not ready. They're not ready.
She is. But what do we say? What's our motto? You got to be ready.
Be ready so you don't have to get ready.
That's right.
Playtime is
over. All my clients out there, they know. All my sizzle speakers and all the folks who are clients know. You've got to be ready so you don't have to get ready. And then last but not least, we have Miss Jayana Wood. Say hey to the folks, Jayana.
Hi, everybody.
So you had a pretty exciting morning this morning.
Yes.
Tell us about it. You want to tell us a little bit about what you did?
Well, today I had to go to this speaking event called Few...
Federally Employed Women.
Yes, and I had to speak there about how courage, confidence, and commitment have helped me to write my first children's book.
Wow. And you're how old?
I'm 10.
You're 10. So when did you write the book?
Last year.
And you were how old?
Nine.
A nine-year-old author, really? What took us so long, you guys? Like, sometimes
we didn't have Cheryl Wood and Powers behind us. That's what happened.
Can you come into the studio every week? Can you come into the studio every week?
I'm sitting here just amazed at, like, younger womanhood in process.
Yes.
Awesome.
Yes. So what do you think about that? You know, sometimes I think to myself, well, gosh, I wish I had discovered my passion for speaking sooner or earlier in life. But then sometimes I think, well, you know, things happen when they're supposed to happen, and maybe I needed the experiences that I had in life. So what are your thoughts on that?
I welcome everyone having a seat at the table, whatever exists. And so I think it's awesome because when you see a young person, you know that's gifting. Mm-hmm. In addition to gifting, she must have amazing parents, family, and a circle of influence pouring into her.
Yeah.
And so that is beautiful in and of itself. And then I think that there is so much to be said for the cultivated beings that we are when we discover these calls on our life, these passions, and this talent, even though it's been expressing itself all along.
Mm-hmm.
I think that every generation gets better with that illuminated awakeness about purpose.
I love that.
That's where you come in, Cheryl Wood, to just continue to cultivate and grow that in so many individuals and women who just are still kind of seeking and discovering.
Yeah, because it's amazing that I meet women as I travel the country and speak at conferences and events, and I coach them, and some women are in their 60s and they don't quite know what their niche is, what their passion is. They're looking for it. I think a lot of times it's because they've spent so much time serving everyone else.
Yes.
That they never took the time to discover who they are, what really nurtures them, what fulfills their spirit. So great point. But we are starting so much younger. I think generationally, we just make sure that we want to give our kids more than what we had. We love our parents for everything they poured into us, but then we want to do even better. I think that's how it should go. What's your thought on that, Sheree?
Definitely leaving a legacy for our kids is so important. And definitely, we definitely want to see our kids do way more than what we did. You know, I know growing up, it wasn't as much a sense of urgency to have your own business or be an entrepreneur as it is today. And not just, you know, say, hey, I'm going to punch in on the clock and I'm going to have a boss that I have to answer to. Now it's like, hey, go get yours and yes, you be the boss.
Absolutely. I mean, entrepreneurship is something huge that we promote in my house. I remember my daughter's already an entrepreneur. She's now a speaker. She's developing her own speaking career. She's an author. But I also have two little boys at home, 6 and 7. And it's amazing how your example, because they do what you do, not what you say, right? So it's amazing how your example can just become this amazing source of inspiration for them. So my sons were on the floor and they're writing and they're coloring and drawing. And I'm saying, what are you guys doing? They each have like, you know, 10 sheets of paper each. And they said, oh, we're drawing because we're going to sell these. I said, okay, well, there goes the entrepreneurial spirit, right? And I love seeing that develop because I think my responsibility is in my own household first, and then in my own zip code, which is my community, and then you take it globally. And I think that's the progression, and that's how it should go. So I don't want to talk anymore without introducing, giving you guys the proper introduction. I'm telling you, I'm learning this thing. This is going to be an interesting journey, but I love it. I'm excited. I think an hour is going to go really, really fast every week. Because when I have amazing women who have great conversation, I think it's going to be hard. But we're going to work it out. So let me just tell you first a little bit about Jennifer, Sheree, and Jayana, so I can give them the official playtime is over welcome. So Jennifer Jones is known among women in Prince George's County as a passionate advocate for women and families in her role as chair of the Prince George's County Commission for Women. Her work as a community servant has championed the needs of women, girls, and their families through programs in education, empowerment, domestic violence, and human trafficking. Her legislative advocacy and work with county, state, and federal government leaders has enriched the work of nonprofit, business, faith-based, and service organizations. She has contributed significantly to the realization of the Global Vision Community Health Center and the formation of the Prince George's County Family Justice Center and Human Trafficking Task Forces, and passionately pursues resources that transform the lives of victims. Now that is a mouthful. You are a busy lady, but it's busy in a good way. Can you tell us what made you get started in all these amazing initiatives for women and girls and families?
Well, Cheryl, what I believe is that when you are given a platform, you should make commitments and honor them to the full, mm-hmm. and to the fullness of your being. And so what's interesting for me is that I've been a champion of service all of my life. I'm a preacher's kid. I'm a preacher's grandkid. I've always been active doing a million things. And when I was given the opportunity to serve on the Commission for Women, I was first vice chair, where we put a lot of structure in place for the organization with hopes that it would never be dismantled again. Mm-hmm. But then I applied what is a business model to do a needs assessment, look at what the needs for women and girls were in the county, and then look at how we could approach trying to address and meet those needs. And so sometimes the needs are to celebrate and champion women, and sometimes it's to really deal with some of the most difficult and challenging mm-hmm. ills, like domestic violence and human trafficking, that plague our community.
Mm-hmm. And so being in that in a role of being such a leader, especially, you know, in Prince George's County, but, you know, it expands so much further than Prince George's County. You know, what is one of the things that you feel is maybe missing in our communities now that used to be in place that's causing sort of a breakdown in the direction of our young girls and our young women as well?
Absolutely. I think that the first important thing is that leadership is about service. Mm-hmm. And so when you approach serving, then you start to look at people not from maybe what's wrong, but how did you get here and how can I redirect you? Mm-hmm. So I approach the needs of women and girls and looking at life transformation, because the challenges don't just resign themselves to zip codes. Mm-hmm. They don't resign themselves to socioeconomic details. It's universal. Prince George's County doesn't just have problems. Right. The entire National Capital Region and the entire world, for mm-hmm. that matter. And so it was truly doing a needs assessment and working in relationship with the county government and leaders of the Department of Social Services, the police, law enforcement, the sheriff's office, and family services, as well as the Office of the County Executive and our elected leaders. Most of the elected leaders know what's happening in their community. Mm-hmm. And so by working collaboratively with these different entities and then welcoming women's organizations, nonprofits, we were able to capture kind of some of the larger challenges. And that's how we approach what we're going to give our attention to. Mental health has been on our books for at least 3 years. Mm-hmm. But in the light of the growing criminal activity, a lot of the violence that's happening, some of the byproducts of domestic violence and human trafficking, along with Alzheimer's and dementia and other illnesses that are affecting our community, plaguing us, suicides, we are going to put a huge initiative towards mental health. Mm-hmm. And so we've created somewhat of a model for how that works, and I'll share more with you about that.
Wonderful. So it sounds like you have a whole gamut of things that you are approaching, but I love the collective approach where you're not just trying to do it as one branch or one division. You're reaching out to all of these different pieces of the puzzle to make it a full initiative or initiatives. Yes. And so I guess my question to you would be, you know, I understand that you're serving, you know, and you're impacting people's lives, but how does the work that you do, how do you feel like it impacts your life? How does it, or does it enhance your own life?
Oh, it absolutely enhances my life. The work is demanding. It's challenging. It requires the best of discipline, focus, planning, timing, and relationship mm-hmm, building. Mm-hmm. Staying focused on your objective more than you care about some of the little nuances and petty things that go on when you're doing service. Mm-hmm. Because it's service. Sometimes people don't want to be served. Sometimes people get territorial. And as a woman, that's kind of personified sometimes. And so you have to manage those things really by just saying to yourself, what's my goal and objective? And so I apply both a business model, a very rich kind of always looking enthusiastically, the glass half full rather than half empty, all of those kind of traditional things that, you know, mm-hmm. we share with people to inspire them. It's what I try to live. Mm-hmm. And what it's done is it's given me experience and cultivated a discipline in me where, you know, things really do kind of roll off like a duck's back, or I really do call and share and dialogue with someone to keep myself and my heart pure mm-hmm. and my intentions pure.
Absolutely. I love that. And I'll tell you, you know, we haven't known each other very long. We actually are connected through an amazing organization that I would be remiss if I didn't shout out today. Absolutely. On this first show, Sisters for Sisters Network Incorporated, with my good friend Peggy Morris. And I know that you are a member of that organization, and Cherie, you're a member of that organization, and Jayana, we're gonna make you a member of that organization as well. We're gonna get them younger and younger. But that's the thing I think that stood out for me was your genuine spirit. And I feel like, you know, as you're on this journey, life journey, entrepreneurial journey, whatever your specific journey is, I feel like as you are making impact, that God will allow certain people to come into your life. And, you know, they say that thing about it, you know, a lifetime or a season or a reason. And I just, but I feel like the more that you're in the journey, he opens your eyes so that you can see the real people who are truly genuine and in it, not for what they can get out of it, but really in it to support you. And that is what, that's the spirit that I got from you. And you called me, I think you emailed me or then you called me and you just wanted to be of service. And literally it blew me away because you don't get that very often.
Well, I thank you, but it's because you're amazing. And I'm going to continue to say that because I literally discovered you, heard about you through Sisters for Sisters and was on the internet
network.
Googling.
You know, they always network, say network.
Absolutely. Sisters for Sisters network. I was on the internet Googling women's organizations, just trying to keep myself abreast of activities. And I saw how to create your own sizzle.
Yeah.
And then I saw and I said, oh, I've heard of Cheryl Wood before. And I was like, this is in Prince George's County. Why doesn't everybody know about this? I immediately called Peggy Morris, the founder, one of the founders and president of Sisters for Sisters Network. And she said, yes, Jennifer, that's Cheryl. And we're going to talk about it on the conference call tonight. And just, I said, I can't stay, but I have to go just to celebrate and be there for your first event.
Yes.
And to pour into you a woman doing something amazing. You're transforming lives and giving people tools and resources. And that's what the work of the commission is about. How do we touch people and transform their lives? If you're in a domestic violence situation, how do we get you safe? How do we get you strong and then get you on a path to being on purpose for your own life? If you're a victim of human trafficking and you can't go home and you're 16, how can we reach out to the organizations and get you the support that you need? That's
Absolutely.
What it's really about.
Absolutely. Well, you're doing great work. And, you know, this is the thing about radio that you can watch. Real stuff happens and you're going to see it, folks. So Sheree and I, we actually rode from this morning, Jayana and I, and I'll tell you about that in a little while. We spoke for an organization called Federally Employed Women.
Yes.
We just literally came from there. And so we parked on the street, but they only allow you to park for an hour. So she has to go back and feed the meter. So I said, hey, this is real time. This is live on the air. This is what happens. You got to feed the meter so you don't go out and then your car is gone.
And Cheryl, I think that's what all of this great work that we're called to do is about. To thine own self be true. Just being real.
Yes.
Feeding the meter is something you have to do. We were at a meeting with 15 women from all over the country to talk about how to move forward with transforming the lives of women of color. And here we were all leaving out going to feed the meter. It's a part of human
Absolutely.
Life and human experience. And I think when we just appreciate the sincerity and authenticity of human life, it moves away ego and personality and objectives and, you know, self-fulfilling things.
Yeah.
And it allows you to focus outside of yourself on things that are bigger than you.
Yeah, and I like to say, you know, be transparent. I love being transparent because I can always show up as me. I can just always show up as Cheryl. I don't ever have to pretend to be somebody else and say, oh, who was I last week? Oh, yeah, I was that person. And at this event, I was that person. Just be authentically who you are.
Absolutely.
And just be real. And I think people gravitate towards that. And so we're going to talk to Sheree. We're going to talk to you a little bit later as well about the We Three conference that's coming up a little later this year. We want to get all the details on that. We're going to talk to Sheree about an expo she has coming up. And right now, we're actually going to direct our attention to the little lady in the house, Miss Jayana Wood. So Jayana, you know, there's been some buzz happening about you. You're this 9-year-old author. Well, now you're 10. You turned 10 in January and you're doing some great things. Why don't you first tell us a little bit about you? What grade are you in? What school do you go to? What's your favorite subjects? Just some general stuff.
Okay. Well, my name is Jayana Wood and I'm a fourth grade A and B student at a French immersion school, and my favorite subject at school is science because we get to do experiments. And sometimes on my free time, when I'm not doing anything, I might just go outside and bounce my basketball or maybe play a video game or something.
Yeah.
And also my favorite two animals are rabbits and horses.
Yes. And she keeps trying to convince me to get a horse. I don't know where the horse is going to go out in our little town home, but, you know, we're trying to figure that one out. Well, that's great. And so tell us about the school that you go to, and do you want to speak a little something for us as a part of telling us about this school?
Oh, well, the name of the school is John Hanson French Immersion, and it's a French school where it goes up to 8th grade, and you speak French, And actually, in my class, we actually do fifth grade math a year above our math level that we're supposed to do. We do fifth grade math.
That's pretty awesome. You're definitely very studious. You're way more advanced than your mama. But it's okay. It's okay. I embrace that. It's okay. So do you want to speak a little French for us? So you know, sometimes people might not really believe. I don't know if you really can speak French. Can you want to say a little something for us?
Okay. Bonjour tout le monde. Mon nom est Jayana Wood. Et c'est très plaisant pour répondre toi.
Wow. Okay, you know my only word that I know. I have three kids in the house who are all going to this French immersion school, which is in Prince George's County. And all I know how to say is, ça va? And what does ça va mean?
Ça va means how are you?
Ça va. So that's what I say all the time to the kids. Ça va. That's the first thing I wake up in the morning.
All I know is we.
We and bonjour. Name. Bonjour. And I try to say it with a little accent, which I don't think works most of the time. Bonjour. But that's great. And so what did you just say to us?
I said, hello, everyone. My name is Jayana Wood, and it's nice to meet you.
Wonderful. And so tell us about this book that you wrote last year. What's the name of the book? What made you write the book?
Well, the name of my book is Opening My Imagination. I also translated the book in French also. And it's pretty much about showing kids the possibilities of what they can do or become as they grow older. And in the book, I just share some of the things that I imagine becoming, that I can become when I grow older.
Awesome. And so what are some of those things? Don't give it all away because we want them to go to Amazon.com and buy the book and support Jayana. But tell us just a few things that you're considering becoming that's listed in the book.
There's a florist, there's a ballerina, and there's a pilot.
I love it. And so you understand, it seems like, that you can do or become anything that you want to become. Why do you believe that? Why do you have that belief?
Well, I mean, because like, you don't really have to, you know, you listen to what other people, well, listen to what people tell you, like, if they're, like, teasing you or things, like, saying, man, you can't do this. You're just, like, you can't do anything you want to do. But you have to believe in yourself, and you have to do what you believe you can do. And don't listen to anyone else if what they say, like, if they say, like, you can't do this, you're never going to accomplish what you really want to do. But as long as you believe in yourself and you put the work into it, you can do whatever you want to do.
I like that. I like that philosophy.
Yeah. Right.
Because what's that? What do we say? What's our motto?
Playtime is over.
Playtime is over. Playtime She knows it. You got to know it. You got to love it. Great stuff.
Awesome.
And so how do you use that? All that inspiration do you use it to empower your little brothers? Because I know, you know, we have two little babies running around the house. Well, they're not really babies. Okay. They're always my babies. 6 and 7, Jalen and James. And what are you going to tell them about doing whatever they want to do? Or do you think you'll be the big sister who teaches them about being an entrepreneur? What's some of the things you think you'll tell them, the advice that you'll give them?
Well, I would tell them that, like, you don't have to, you can do whatever you want to do. Mm-hmm. And if other people are saying you can't do it, you just have to believe in yourself and believe that you can do it. Like, one time, James, he said he wanted to become a policeman. So he has to, you know, just start practicing, you know, like
learning how to arrest people, huh?
I guess so. Yeah.
He practices that on his brother. They roughhouse quite a bit around the house.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I think that's great advice. And so we want you to keep being an inspiration to your brothers and to other little kids who are looking and saying, well, I want to do this or I want to become that, but maybe I'm too young. You're showing people that you can start at any age. You can start very young. I mean, an author at 9 years old, that's pretty amazing. So thank you for sharing your story with us. We're going to ask you some more questions throughout this interview today, okay?
Okay.
Are you proud of your mommy?
Yes.
Woohoo! Playtime is over.
I hope
you guys are enjoying the conversation so far. I hope you're out there tweeting and Facebooking using hashtag PTIO Radio. We want to hear your feedback about the dynamic conversation we're having. Again, this show is all about uplifting and empowering and inspiring you and sharing some great stories of people in our own community who are doing amazing things, not just for themselves, but for others, and who are creating a legacy, as I like to say, that will long outlive your physical body. And that's the question that I want you to ask yourself. Are you playing small right now in life? Or are you playing bigger? Are you thinking big and making the decision that you're going to go for it, whatever the thing is. And look, this is what you've got to say. You've got to say, what's the worst that can happen? If it, Willie Jolly says, if it doesn't involve death, then go for it. Exactly. You might as well go for it. So thank you again, Jayana. So we're going to keep the conversation rolling, and we're going to turn over to Miss Cherie Cofield. Mm-hmm. And let me introduce her appropriately. So Cherie is the founder and CEO of Cherie Cofield International. She's the founder of the annual Let's Get Serious Health, Wellness, and Fitness Expo. She's been a licensed practical nurse for 24 years. You don't look like you that old, girl.
I know, don't tell nobody.
24 years. An international number one Amazon best-selling author of her book, The Crash That Altered My Life. She's a speaker, recently titled Miss Owings Mills, Maryland, as a part of the Miss Corporate America pageant. And she's the host of her own radio show. So thank you for gracing us with your presence today. And that show is To Your Health Radio Show. Again, welcome.
Thank you. Thank you. I wouldn't miss it for the world. I'm so proud of you, girl.
Thank you. Okay, you guys got to know that Cherie and I are twins.
We're twins.
We're twins. Twin so she power. Had to be here. You know, anything I do, she has to be in the kickstart,
right.
The jump off. But she has been one of my greatest supporters. She is at everything that I do. She is, okay, can I share what I call you?
Oh, goodness. What do you call
she's
me?
She's my pit bull. She is
everybody needs a pit bull.
She is officially my pit bull who gets things done behind the scenes. She doesn't take any stuff. She will tell you about yourself. Okay, maybe I shouldn't go
don't
there.
Go but, there girl. Goodness.
But she's an amazing woman, an amazing heart-centered woman who just is about her business, and she doesn't believe in foolishness. And I love that about her. And so I love having her in my inner circle. But I want you to talk to us about all the great things you're doing, especially as a part of the Let's Get Serious Health, Wellness, and Fitness Expo that's coming up this weekend.
Saturday. It is here.
Woo. Tell us about it and how it evolved and why you decided to start it.
Okay, so this is the fourth annual Let's Get Serious Health, Wellness, Fitness Expo. And let me tell you, I start out planning a year in advance. So when people come out Saturday, I already have the date for next year's expo.
I love it.
So the year went by so quick. I'm like, wow, what is going on here? But anyway, the motivation behind the expo is, of course, you already know the story, Cheryl, so I'm going to turn my attention this way.
Yes.
I'm going to talk to the people.
I'm excited.
Well, 4 years ago on Thanksgiving Day, our dad, David Michael Swan, we got that tragic phone call that he died in his sleep from a heart attack at 59 years old. And as far as we knew, his overall health was good. You know, he had some things he could, you know, brush up on, as we all could, as far as our health and wellness. But to get that call, I thought they were calling me to say, hey, how much turkey, you know, and gravy do you want? And they were calling to say, I'm sorry, you know, your dad is gone. And to hear that, I felt like, wow, did we miss something? So I started this initiative, the Let's Get Serious Expo, as a way to bring families together to get educated on health, wellness, fitness, what to eat, getting tested, getting physicals. And if you don't have insurance, the Let's Get Serious Expo is the place to be, because it's totally free. I don't charge a dime. The only thing people spend money on when they come out is if they want to shop with some of our vendors. So it's been phenomenal. I mean, the numbers are jumping out of the roof. I can remember the first one. Cheryl, do you remember the first one?
I remember.
150 people. And now for this year, we already have over 900 people registered to attend. So it's just really taken off. I'm so happy to see that so many people are interested in their health and their wellness, you know, just taking that journey to live a better and healthier lifestyle.
Absolutely. And you know, I can say I've been there every year as a part of this dynamic event. And I think my favorite part includes the healthy food samples. Wow. Okay, I like to eat. but at least it's healthy at this event.
Right.
And then also the demonstrations in terms of the exercise and the fitness. So I know, yes, you have people who come and do Zumba and kickboxing. Tell us about that.
Yes. Oh, wow. We do 20-minute power workouts. So if you say, hey, I want to exercise, but I don't want to do the same boring thing. I don't want to just go lift a machine. I want to be, you know, I want to have fun with it. Well, this is the place to be, because we do 20-minute power workouts. And I mean, we have 9 instructors this year.
Mm-hmm.
So we extended the expo for a couple more hours this year. It's from 12 noon to 5 p.m. So you can work out all day with us if you want. We have 2 Zumba sessions. We have cardio kickboxing with Good Fit for Life. We have TXT. A gentleman's coming all the way from California to take part in the expo.
West Coast, coming to the East Coast.
Coming to the East Coast, Tafiq Akure. He's coming all the way from California. So happy to have him. And his brother, he reached out to me and he said, hey, I want to be a part of that initiative to get people healthy. And maybe we should bring you to California too. And I said, I'm all for it. Let's go.
Can you pack me in a suitcase and bring me with you?
Come on now. You don't even
twin
have
powers,
ask.
Twin powers.
I'm
see?
Here now.
Jennifer. It'll be a girl's trip before we know it. And my husband will be saying, what? I know you're not trying to leave me with the kids.
And listen, we even have stuff like hula hoop fitness. We have a lady that's going to do hula hoop fitness. There are some things I had never heard of, like work. W-E-R-Q. I had never heard of work. Wow. So I'm looking forward to seeing what that's all about. And Bokwa, which is African, I guess, stimulated or African...
Influence.
Influence. Yeah. Thank you. Help me out, girl. Yeah, African influence. So I'm excited because I get to actually participate because I got Completely Yours events to help me out the day of the event. They're going to be taking over so I can do the interviews and I can work out and I can practice what I'm preaching to others.
I love that. I love that. Practice what you preach. And you do such an amazing job at pulling in so many great resources. I mean, you have tables upon tables upon tables of people who are just there to provide resources. Yes. Don't you have people who come in and do blood pressure and things like that?
Yes. We have a total this year of 63 vendors. Wow. And I can count on one hand the vendors that are selling something outside of health and wellness. So the main focus of the entire expo is health, wellness, fitness. So we have the Vein Clinics of America going to be there. They're going to do free vein assessments. So if you have those varicose veins and you want to see, hey, could I possibly be getting a clot or anything in my legs? Come on out. They're going to test you for free. I mean, like, that's unheard of.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then we have, like, blood pressure monitoring. You can actually find out the status of your kidneys from the American Kidney Fund, and they're going to mail the results to you. We have free HIV and AIDS testing. I mean, everything that you can think of, you can get it right there at the Let's Get Serious Expo.
Powerful. I love it. And you know what I really love about it as well is that it's family-oriented. There is not a lot of stuff that you can go to as a family, but then add free, F-R-E-E, onto the end of it. Look, I'm a family of 5. My husband, myself, my 3 kids, and we go to the movies and we spend $100, or we go to dinner and we spend $100. So to come to something free, and I think last year you had, what I love was that you had the Wii Fit.
Yes,
and
yes.
So the kids could get exercise. So everything is surrounding this theme of being healthy and fit and taking care of yourself. Yeah. So how do people find out more? What's the date? To reemphasize the date. How can they connect with you?
Okay, so the Let's Get Serious, the 4th annual Let's Get Serious Health, Wellness, Fitness Expo is being held this Saturday, that's April the 5th, from 12 noon to 5 p.m. in Baltimore at the Inn at the Colonnade. It's a DoubleTree Hotel located at 4 West University Parkway. You can register online at letsgetserious2014.eventbrite.com. Again, registration is free. We don't have any vendor spaces left. We sold out of vendor spaces. Everybody wants to get in on this initiative.
Because that's the sizzling hot event of the year. That's why. Sizzling
it's
hot.
Where you want to be.
So let's get serious. 2014.eventbrite.com.
Eventbrite.com.
Go there, register, bring your family, bring your kids, get some of the free food samples. But also get some free exercise, get to moving. I mean, that's one of my big goals for this year is to really become more active and make sure I'm making my health and wellness just as important as pursuing my business and taking care of the kids and everything else. So keep up the great work. We're going to be looking for all the photos and the pictures. I am like in the doghouse because I will not be there this year.
Boo.
I'm so sorry.
But I'm so excited. I'm sitting here mesmerized like, okay, I'm trying to get the website. One more time. Tell me how.
It's Let's Get Serious 2014.eventbrite, and that's BRITE.com. So Let's Get Serious 2014.eventbrite.com.
It's good stuff. Awesome. I'm telling you, you don't want to miss this event at the Colonnade, the Inn at the Colonnade in Baltimore, Maryland. Make sure you check out that website. And then how do folks connect with you on social media?
Sheree Colefield, INT. I had to think about myself. Like, you don't connect with yourself on social media. So I was like, let me think for a minute. So Sheree, C-H-E-R-E. Cofield, C-O-F as in Frank, I-E-L-D, and then I-N-T, short for international. So Sheree Colefield International or Sheree Colefield International 2, because Facebook, y'all done blown me up.
I know. What's that with Facebook? I don't want to get put off the air for talking about Facebook. Uh-oh. But I mean, you tell us to be social, and then you only allow us to have 5,000 friends.
What's up with that?
Right? All right. Well, good stuff. Thank you so much for sharing. And, you know, my family will be there to support the event. I'll be off in Munster, Indiana. I had never heard of Munster, Indiana before this, but I actually have a speaking engagement there. But I'll be representing the Twin Power as well. And you'll be here representing the Twin Power as well.
And your husband will be doing the balloon characters for the kids. He is amazing.
That is a multi-talented man.
Yes, he is.
And, I got to give a shout out to that man, because I tell you, we cannot do what we do without the behind the scenes, the people are supporting. James Wood, you are thebomb.com. You want to give daddy a shout out, Gianna? Thank you for your love and for your support. And I know you're watching this, and hopefully I'm making you proud. And, you know, I know you'll critique me when I get home later.
I don't have anything in my teeth, do I, James?
Can I just add that being chair of the Commission for Women, people often think that we are so pro-women that we are not thinking about men and boys. But I want to shout out to your husband and to all the men out there who support women, who help us be amazing, who balance our lives, have our backs, and just help us get it done. And all the boys, all of the young men who are out there looking forward to future, know that we as women, as mothers, as professionals, whatever role you connect with us in, know when we push you, it's because we want you to be all man. We want to see you get there. So a lot of love to the brothers.
Thank you. Awesome. Good stuff. Now, see, we'll get real fancy later, and I'll have like a little machine with the hand clapping. And the next time I'll have, when the person has their event, I'll have it up on the screen. I'm not that fancy yet, but we will get there. My hubby, he's the IT guru. He'll help me pull some stuff together.
That's right. We'll burn some calories clapping on out.
We clap all day long.
And I'm looking forward to it. I'm trying to figure out how can I go to the Early Childhood Education Conference, make it to you, and then go see Oprah.
I love
it. I can't wait to share this vital information.
From what I hear, you know, me and Cherie, we trying to be like you when we grow up, Jennifer. You got a driver.
I want a driver.
You know, we trying to be like you.
God is good. It was at 2 o'clock getting here for your first radio show. There was nothing more important. So as I was panicking and freaking, and then I got out of the car and ran up the block like, okay, what's up?
I love it. And you also have this amazing initiative coming up. I want you to tell our audience all about the We 3 Conference, why it got started, and what they can expect, the date, how they register, all that good information.
Absolutely. The We 3 Conference, We 3 stands for Women Educated, Women Empowered, and Women Engaged. Mm. And the We 3 Conference is a day of empowerment and of education and getting women to connect. We put together a committee of all of the leading women's organizations in Prince George's County and dynamic women leaders, community servants, and commissioners to come together to pick a date and time where we could just pause and learn not just about our own selves, our health and our safety and economics, our financial strength and all of those things, but then to take things one step further and understand the relationship between our everyday lives, whether you're talking about having your snow shoveled or a pothole fixed in your neighborhood, all the way up to the decisions that impact us as a community. How do the students get laptops or get notebooks or iPads in the school system? What are you doing politically on a local, state, and federal level to ensure that our needs for ourselves and our families are being met, that we are community-minded? In Prince George's County, we have this unique fact that a statewide election, in order to win a statewide election, you need Prince George's County and Baltimore City, Baltimore County. Mm. In our county, 51 to 54% of the voting block are women. And so for you to win a countywide or statewide election, it's women putting you in office. And so with that responsibility, we vote. Then it's inherent upon us to leverage the power of that vote to ensure that decisions are made in the best interests of our families, our youth, our businesses, and things that promote and support women. Mm-hmm. And so the We 3 Conference this year is in its third year. It's scheduled for September 20th. The conference is going to be held at the Comfort Inn Hotel in Bowie, Maryland this year. We've been traditionally at Prince George's Community College. The college is undergoing some renovations, so we're going to be off-site for this year. But the We 3 Conference, you can go online and register for the conference starting in June. Our website is we3wlc.com. And you can learn more about us. Cheryl, we will be back with you in whatever way we can promote and awesome. Publicize the conference through you and through this show. We're going to definitely support you and do everything in our power just to get women to come out for a day and engage our elected leadership, because they are making decisions every day about our lives, and yes. they really do enthusiastically want to hear, what do we want? What are our priorities as they make these decisions?
Good, good, good stuff. And so, you know, we go to a lot of conferences, and yeah, we want to be empowered and inspired and motivated. I mean, I am the queen of that, right? But also what I love about this is that it has a purpose. It is strategically designed to help women understand their power. And sometimes as women, we know it in the back of our minds, but we don't use it. And we've got to start leveraging our buying power, our political power, our power to leverage our connections with each other and to collaborate.
Absolutely.
It's our obligation. It's our responsibility to do it. And I love that you shared those statistics. So again, tell us the date of the conference and where people can go to get their tickets or register.
Absolutely. The date of the conference is Saturday, September 20th, 2014, and you can go to our website at we3wlc.com, and we will be able to be Googled on Eventbrite.
Fantastic. And so make sure you connect. If you miss any of that information, you can certainly reach out to me on Facebook or Twitter. I'm at Cheryl Empowers. You can reach out to Jennifer. I believe you're on Facebook. And just make sure that you get this information, because we need to spread the word. We need to pack the house, where we actually have to say, oh, we need a bigger venue next year.
And
we want to pack the house.
Cheryl, if you don't mind, just in our committee meeting last week, I invited you to participate in the We3 conference. The first half of the day is going to be a forum where there'll be interactive education and panel discussions, mm-hmm. and the second half is going to be an empowerment luncheon, mm-hmm. where we're going to inspire and profile yes. women who have done amazing things, and you're going to be there with us to kind of kick off the morning and to then help us make it through that empowerment luncheon.
Awesome.
And we're just excited about having you join us this year. It's amazing. I'm amazing, and just sharing you and your story, the radio show today with all of the women on the committee, they were just blown away and excited.
See, she's gonna have me in tears up in here. See that? We didn't talk about that. I didn't know. I mean, the discussion was there. We talked again. You know, Jennifer has been so gracious in connecting with me and wanting to share her resources and help me to expand my reach.
Absolutely.
And my message. And I so value that. But I always come into any relationship knowing that sometimes you've got to give before you ask. And
Absolutely.
So I don't come into any relationship asking, what can you do for me? Like, uh-huh. that's not the way to go about it. But every time you come in with the spirit of service and giving and impacting other people's lives, it comes full circle. And so that is, well, make me tear up on this show. that is so exciting. I'm excited to be a part of it. I think it's great work that you're doing. I love, again, love your genuine spirit. So we are actually, you know, we are about, what, 5 or 6 minutes, maybe 7 minutes into wrapping up this show. I cannot believe that we are coming to the top of the hour. This has been so exciting. Again, if you're tuning in, I just want you to know that this is Playtime is Over Radio Show. Our hashtag on Twitter and Facebook is PTIO Radio. We want you to shout us out. Let us know that you tuned into the show today. Tell us about any exciting information. Jayana's over here waving. She has people texting her, and the ladies, Jennifer and Cherie, they're texting and tweeting and Facebooking. You got to be active on social media.
That's right.
And again, it's really, my mission is simple. It is to become the best version of me so that I can give the best of me to everyone that I serve. My clients, my children, my husband, my anyone that I partner with, collaborators. I can't give the best of me to you unless I am the best. And so that means I have to continue pouring into myself, investing, being a student, and just taking some risks. And this radio show is one of those examples of taking a risk, being scared, but doing it anyway, you know, not knowing, you know, should I do it? Should I not do it? Is it really going to add value? You know, can I hang in there? Can I commit? And just taking the leap. Sometimes as women, I feel like we overthink. We overthink.
Yes.
And sometimes you just got to jump in with both feet. What's the worst that can happen? and believe in yourself, believe in your ability to make great things happen. I tell my clients all the time, you are not waiting for greatness to show up. Greatness is waiting for you to show up. Mm. And you, the power is in your hands. God has already pre-approved you. He's already appointed you that, yes, you have greatness within. You don't need more. You don't need more education, more resources, more anything. You are enough just as you are. And once I got that philosophy in my mind and really in my heart and started believing it, all these doors started opening because that belief connected to action. And the action is what gets you results. Action is what, not hoping and praying and wishing and telling your girlfriends about it. That's good. That sounds good. So what's the action that you're putting behind the goals, the aspirations, the dreams, so that you can actually, it can go from a, what I call a possibility to a probability to a reality. The more you sacrifice for it, the more you work for it, it goes through that channel, that funnel, possibility to a probability to a reality. And there's nothing that's holding you back. So I always want to kind of end the show, close out on kind of a fun note, and this is something I thought I would add. So I'm just going to throw out some things, and I want you all to respond to these things and just kind of go around the table. All right, so the one thing I can't live without.
God.
See, Sheree got so many things she can't. Right? She cannot live without her stilettos. She can't live without them fancy. I told her today, I said, girl, you're so fancy. You're so fancy. I love it.
Wow.
We'll come back to you, Jayana.
Family.
Family. Ooh.
It's beautiful.
Wow. I would say my kids.
Your kids.
That's one, but I got so many.
She got, okay, right. You give us a list. We'll share it next week on next week's show. My favorite leisure activity is
dancing.
Oh, we got to go dancing.
We have to go dancing.
Look, before I had three kids, I was a dancing fool. My husband will tell you, that's a whole nother show. But,
but I got pictures, y'all. I got pictures.
It's good for the soul. It's good for the soul. Yeah.
Singing.
Sing. Oh, yes. Yes. You want to bust a note for us before you get off the air?
Really?
Okay, we come back to you. Jayana. My favorite leisure activity. The thing you like to do in your free time.
Sleeping?
You don't like to sleep that much.
I'm with you.
What about drawing? You love to draw.
Yeah, I like drawing and coloring.
Yeah, drawing and coloring. Awesome. Sheree, did you want to bust a note?
If I could, I'd protect you from the sadness in your eyes. Give you courage in a world of compromise. Yes, I would, if I could.
Woo!
Awesome!
Woo!
Talk about multi-talented.
So you cannot be ready. You can not only hire her to speak, but then she can bust out in a song. She can bust a note for you. She can teach you how to manage your stress as you writing out that check to pay her to come and bust a note for you.
I love it. I love it. I love it.
All right, two more. So the one place in the world that I must visit, if you haven't already, the one place in the world I must visit.
Dubai.
France,
of course. Francois, how you say it? Huh? El Francois, Francais. Okay, let me just stick to English. Okay. And last but not least, the one word that best describes me. The one word that best describes me. Everybody's thinking, do, 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 do.
Happy.
Happy.
Strategic.
That is one of my goals for 2014 is to be much more strategic. Yeah, I like that. Jayana, the one word that best describes you.
Energetic. I can't keep still.
So maybe you say ADD.
We all claim it as adults.
Yes. So we are wrapping up. You know, I have totally enjoyed this kickoff show. Yes, I hope you guys out there have enjoyed it as much. The conversation was amazing. Thank you for being here to celebrate this with me, for helping me to get through this with my nerves and being scared.
Well, you do nervous very well. If you were nervous, you did great.
You didn't know.
We'll take you nervous every week.
I love it. We'll take you nervous every week.
We're so honored to be here for
Thank
you. This
you.
Is amazing.
Thank you. We're going to take this thing. We're going to have the highest rated show on WLBS. Yes. We're putting that out into the universe.
Speaking into existence.
Yes, we're speaking that into existence. And for all of you out there, make sure that you tune in next Tuesday, same time, same place, 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. We're going to have two special guests, Miss Christine Saintville of Moms in Charge and Miss Joan Henry, who does a very dynamic women's conference called Women's Entrepreneur Expo. We're going to be talking to both of them and talking to them about how they're living by this model of playtime being over. The thing that you've got to remember is that there's no time for excuses, distractions, fears, negative self-chatter, self-limits. Those are the things we've got to dump off. Yes. And we've got to make sure that we step into our God-given greatness without apologies or regrets. Thank you so much for tuning in. And we will see you next Tuesday on Playtime is Over Radio. Hashtag PTIO Radio. Thank you.
Playtime's over.
Playtime's over.
Playtime's over. Playtime's over. Yeah.
Might seem crazy.